and fro. Everybody is busy doing the things that they're doing. And sometimes we say we haven't got time for the Lord, but it's time and high time that we take time for the Lord Jesus Christ and let everybody else know. I tell you what, I've got an obligation to Him, and every single day we got an obligation to Him to call upon His name and to read His word and let everybody know that everything is right between me and Lord. I tell you, I talk to Him day after day. I said, Lord, if there's anything in between me and You that is not right, I said, I ask You to take it out, because we're all getting to the age we don't know exactly what's going to happen. Some people's health is failing them. We got two people in rehab right now, and they're trying their best to figure out exactly what's wrong with them. And there are people that sit in the pews, and when they sat here, they were so faithful, and they were so in the church and done a lot of different things in this life, but we find out through all these things that they are faithful, but yet something's happened, and soon and very soon we're going to see the King. We're going to see the one that died for us and the one that gave His life for us. We know through Him all things are possible, and it's very important that you got your heart right with the Lord, because He's coming soon. Now, there's a lot of people says a lot more that's going to be fulfilled than what's fulfilled for Jesus Christ to come. But I'm telling you something. There's no more in here that I know of that's got to be fulfilled for the church to leave. There's a lot of things going to come to pass after the church is gone, and the end is not yet. And I tell you what, the church is going to rapture out before the end comes. And we're going to see Jesus for the first time. And like the song that Lauren has sung a while ago, would it be a blessed hope to you when you see Jesus for the first time and you know that you have toiled, but you've got this thing in your heart accepting Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and you know you accepted Him whether you was young or whether you're old, and we had troubles and trials, but Jesus talked about it. He said, my little children, these things are right unto you that you sin not, but if you do sin, we have an advocate with the Father Himself. We need to ask Jesus to forgive us for the things we've done wrong and get our heart ready. A lot of people are looking for a great revival, which it might happen. A lot of people are looking for a lot of different things happening in this life. But I'm looking and hearing the trumpet sound. And when the trumpet sounds, Jesus is going to step out on a cloud and tell the church to come home. What a glorious day that's going to be. I want to ask everybody a question in here today. Are you ready? Are you ready if the Lord was to come today? Do you know Him as your personal Savior? Have you asked Him to forgive you of your sins? Have you got everything fixed up? You might have everything fixed up in this life. You might be retired. You might be on Social Security. You might have a little money in the bank. And you kind of lay back, say everything is all right with me. I don't have to worry about nothing. But tomorrow might be the day that you're going to see the Lord. I believe every single person and ever lived on the face of this earth, I believe they're going to see Jesus one day. And I believe they're going to have to give account of everything they said in this life, whether it's good or whether it's bad. We need to be ready when the Lord comes. I know through all things, I tell you, God has kept us through everything there is in this life. He reigns on the just and He reigns on the unjust. But one day, you're going to stand there before Jesus. Your mom and dad won't be there. Your brother and sister won't be there. You're going to stand before the Lord yourself, and you're going to give account of everything done in this life that you've not asked forgiveness of. And I tell you, it's very important to be ready when the Lord calls. Is anybody here today that would like to accept Him as their Lord and Savior? Have you thought about your life where you're going to spend eternity? Have you thought about it at all that Jesus is going to come? Have you thought about the earthquakes? Brother Kenny was talking about it. Have you thought about the earthquakes all down through Tennessee and Kentucky? They're having more earthquakes than they've ever seen before. And they're having earthquakes in different places. And the Bible talked about them having earthquakes in different places. That's different places. We find out that through all this, that the Lord is coming. He's coming soon. And there's storms, and breaking storms. Brother Jerry was talking about the locusts. And everything. They put the crops out, the locusts come through. And I'm telling you what, it just devours everything there is. And see, my That type is of a land that's coming back to us now. And I tell you, all the diseases. And the Bible said in the 24th chapter of Matthew that there's going to be pestilence and earthquakes in different places. The pestilence is diseases that's coming up on us. I don't know how many people's already died already from these pestilence that's coming up on us. And it's the Word of God. We can't stand against the Word of God. Whatever the Word says, it's going to be there. It's going to come to pass, no matter what the situation is. But I'm going to make an altar call. And you that don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, it's time that you made a change. It's time that you get ready for this supper. We've all made excuses throughout our life why we can't do things for the Lord Jesus Christ. But after a while, all the time is over of what you have done in this life. And I tell you, only what's done for Christ will going to last. When they come back to...